I think it should be, but oftentimes it's not. I think that quite often in today's world we find ourselves unable to truly understand grace, unable to truly understand what it means to be gracious and graceful, and unable to demonstrate grace on a day-to-day basis. I think that if we need to dive into this question and ask the question, is Christian grace different from non-Christian grace? We need to first understand what we mean by Christian grace and non-Christian grace. I think that grace, just the word, not even considering Christian or non-Christian, is a very misunderstood concept. And I think that it takes a lot of effort and willpower to try and understand and demonstrate grace. We first need to understand what Christian grace is. Are we talking about the grace of a Christian or the Christian concept of grace? Because those, in practicality, are two very different things. I, as a Christian, can show grace, but is it true grace? Is it Christian grace? Is it Jesus's grace? Those are three very different things. I know that oftentimes, even as a Christian, I stumble and fall and do not show grace the way that I should. What's my benchmark? What's my platform for how to show grace? Is it my own idea and philosophy of what grace is and how it should look? Or is it the example that Jesus showed? And I think that that's the question for a Christian to be asking. Am I going to go by what the world says about grace? Or am I going to go by what Jesus says about grace? Grace in its truest form can only come from Jesus himself. Because he is not bound by our limitations. He is not bound by or born into sin. And I know that as a Christian, we're technically not bound by sin because we've received freedom in Christ. But oftentimes we find ourselves falling back to a way of living that doesn't glorify Jesus and doesn't show grace. I think that Jesus, because he is God and the full embodiment of God, is the only one who can indeed show grace. And that comes from his ability to shake off and to put away all the things that as humans stop us from showing grace. The ill temper, the bad language, the bad attitudes, the unforgiveness. You see, God cannot deny himself. So that means it's actually impossible for God not to be gracious. Because it is who he is. It is his character. He cannot not show grace. He cannot not be grace. And I think that oftentimes Christians don't even really consciously think, is what I'm doing emulating Jesus? Because as a Christian, that's what we're supposed to be doing, is emulating Jesus, not emulating ourselves or the world. Because as a Christian, you say that you are a born-again believer in Jesus. You are a new creation. You are a new person, born again of the Spirit of God. And if that's true, then just like a baby becomes like his parents, so does a new Christian become like his Heavenly Father. And so if you're truly born again, you cannot help but become more gracious. You cannot but help become more loving and more like Jesus on a day-to-day basis. Do we always get this right? No, we don't. as we've seen in some of these clips, Christians can be far from grace and far from gracious. For a human, whether he is non-Christian or Christian, to be able to show grace, you need to first encounter it. And we live in a world today where grace is so undercut and so undershown that it is nearly impossible for anyone to say they have experienced true grace. When you come into contact with Jesus, you come into contact with grace. He shows you that unconditional grace that you can only receive from Him. A heavenly Father who has no limitations, who has no limitations. He cannot show you anything but grace. And so when you come into this and you experience grace, you experience this unconditional level of grace that transforms you from the inside out, then you can say, I know grace. But if you've been raised in a place similar to where I was raised, where you were never shown grace, where you were never taught grace in its truest form, where you never experienced that perfect level of grace that only Jesus can provide, you come out with a warped perception of grace. You come out with a perception of grace that may be, well, who needs it? My parents said that they loved me. They said they were gracious, but then they kicked me and beat me behind closed doors. How can we expect to come up with a healthy understanding of grace if we've never known it? All of us, whether Christian or non-Christian, have been born into this world of disconnection from God. Every single person living, whether Christian or non-Christian, has to at some point make a decision to follow Jesus and become a newborn Christian. It's at that point where you encounter grace, where you encounter true grace and true love. And until that moment, I don't think anyone can show grace, because He is the only person who can show that unconditional grace, because He is not bound by the things that we are bound by. That's what makes Him God and us not. In conclusion, what I'm trying to say is, who is the author of grace? Where do you get your standard of grace from? A non-Christian who has never truly encountered Jesus could say that their grace, their understanding of grace, was shaped by their experiences of it. See, there is no hard and fast rule in the non-Christian world of what grace is. It's down to your experience of it. And if you've never experienced true grace, you're going to have a warped understanding of it. To have a true understanding of grace, we first need to experience true grace. And I believe that the only way that that can be done is through a personal encounter with Jesus. Since He is the full embodiment and personification of grace, and He is not bound by sin and bound by human flesh, He is the only person who can show grace unconditionally and unmeritedly. This means that when you come into contact with Jesus and you experience that grace, then and only then are you able to show grace. To finish up, let me show you this video.
Law commands us to stone such a woman. What do you say?
It's a trap. Thank you. I'll give my stone to the first man who tells me that he has never sinned.
From that beautiful picture of grace, we can see that the religious leaders, the Pharisees that were standing there to accuse that woman and stone her because of her adulterous actions, are just like the Christians in the videos that we showed at the beginning of this video. They were standing there with signs of accusation and signs of judgment and condemnation. How is it that the people of God can be so unlike God himself? We can see that Jesus, however, has a completely different way of dealing with sin, and that is by grace, by extending love, and by extending care. And this is the kind of grace that we as Christians need to emulate. This is the kind of grace that is going to change the world.